Hot weather and rain are gone, replaced by dry, cooler weather.
And that means the brush fire season is here. And for the second day in a row, local firefighters are battling a brush fire.
Now, this one in Volusia County started late this morning. It grew quickly to 10 acres, sending smoke and haze into the skies over Holly Hill, Ormond Beach, and Daytona Beach.
We do have team coverage of the fire threat. Meteorologist Dan Billow and Jason Brewer are standing by with more on the conditions creating the threat.
We begin with West 2's Craig Lucy, who's live with the late-breaking details on the fire in Volusia County. Craig?
Jim, this fire started around 3 o'clock this morning. It is now about 90% contained. We're several hundred yards away from the flames right now, but off in the distance, as you mentioned, you can kind of make out the smoke over there in the air. Right now, the flames are pretty much, again, contained, and the winds are cooperating with firefighters, but they're keeping an eye on the winds just in case they shift later on this afternoon. Small fires continue to flare up. The 10-acre brush fire near Oak Street and Avenue K in Holly Hill is not threatening homes now, but that could change.
There's a neighborhood behind the fire here, so if the wind changed direction, it could push that direction.
The fire broke out early Thursday morning. Investigators will be passing through the rugged terrain looking for a cause. For now, though, firefighters are dousing hot spots and digging plow lines.
Even though the expansion's been stopped for now, it's certainly the threat hasn't been entirely removed.
Flying embers could be kicked up by afternoon winds, and when the humidity is around 20% to 30%, the dry brush surrounding the already burned area could easily ignite.
There's still the potential for this fire to escape again. In addition, the wind speeds are supposed to pick up this afternoon.
So far, the Division of Forestry says residents are in the clear. One neighbor says seeing flames so close to his home is nothing new this time of year.
A couple years ago, it was right across the street, and they put it out. They're always good at putting these fires out.
The Division of Forestry says right now we are approaching the end of the wet season, and all of this land back here is usually swampland, and there was a ditch. There is a ditch right here, but normally it is filled up with water. You can see it's completely dry, and that's the way it is back there. So they're really concerned about the dry winter months ahead and facing much bigger fires than the one that they have on their hands right now. Reporting live in Volusia County, Craig Lucy, West 2 News.
Today's fire is fairly small, but the worst is still likely yet to come.
West 2 meteorologist Dan Billow is live in Cape Canaveral with more on why the danger is higher this year. Dan?
And Martha, a dry weather pattern all summer, or much of the summer, with a lot of easterly flow that's kept storm inland, has kept our coastal counties very dry, much drier than usual. So there's a lot of this around. And going into the dry season, it's likely to get even drier. Central Florida's wildfires can rage on for days and at times consume entire neighborhoods. With fires already starting to appear as this year's dry season begins, it looks like we're in for a long one, potentially very long and very dry. Red flag warnings are up in Central Florida. That's today's fire danger due to steady wind and low humidity. But the Keach-Byram Drought Index shows what may be in store. Already moderate drought conditions exist over much of Central Florida. Orange and Osceola counties are in the normal range, but the coast is especially dry. And because of a wet spring and dry summer, fire danger could get serious. In the spring, a rain surplus of more than 2 inches promoted a lot of vegetation growth. A summer rain deficit of more than a foot since May 1st has dried out much of that growth. Fire officials say piles of debris constitute some of the greatest danger. It's time for folks to take protective measures.
With our county becoming as populated as it is, we're going to see more and more of that occurrence of fire in our neighborhoods.
And those rain deficit numbers you just saw are for Melbourne, so especially dry here in Brevard County. Red flag warnings have been dropped now for Seminole, Orange, Osceola, and inland Volusia County, but we're likely to see plenty more red flag warnings in the months ahead. We're live in Cape Canaveral. Dan Billow, West 2 News.
Dan, thanks so much.